Hello students, today we will be discussing about types of contracts, or we can say classification of contracts. Here we can categorize them into three: classification based on validity, classification based on formation, classification based on performance. Classification based on validity. A contract is formed on the basis of an agreement. An agreement would become a valid contract when all the essential elements of a contract are present. If in case one or more essential elements of the contract are missing, then it would be either voidable, void, illegal, or unenforceable contract, but not a valid contract. Classification based on formation. Contract may be made or formed either by writing or by word of mouth or inferred from the conduct of the parties or the conditions or situations of the case. Classification based on performance. The extent up to which contracts can be performed or categorized. Say, is it an executed contract or executory contract, unilateral or one-sided contract, or bilateral contract. So therefore, today we will be discussing in detail regarding the classification of contracts. We will be studying about various differences among void contract, voidable contract, and illegal contract. So these are the topics which we will be discussing in today's class. So, classification based on validity. Here we have again subdivide them into what is voidable contract, what is a void agreement and void contract, what is an illegal agreement, unenforceable contract. So when we discuss about classification based on validity, so we should know these four aspects: what is a voidable contract, what is void agreement or void contract, and the illegal agreement, unenforceable contract. Let us discuss them in detail. Voidable contract. Section 2(1) of the Indian Contract Act defines an agreement that is enforceable by law at the option of one or more of the parties thereto, but not at the option of other or others, is a voidable contract. So this is very, very important. See, you should have a clear idea about the term void and the term voidable. So let me explain in detail. Void means a contract is void, it cannot lead to enforcement by either party. This is a contract that is no longer usable. The law will then treat the contract as if the two parties never formed any type of agreement between them or any legally binding obligations. A contract is void when one party attempts to accomplish something that is either impossible or illegal in the state or country. If both parties engage in these similar activities, the void contract will not support them through any type of relationship or business dealing. So void, please be clear. So here void in the sense, no longer it is usable. It is not usable. And any legally binding obligation exists. Okay, in void. Coming to the voidable, here a voidable contract can proceed through the court enforcing the clauses because it is a valid agreement between the two parties. In these situations, when one party will remain bound to the terms of the contract, while the other may only need to supply something such as payment or another item of value. The unbound party can cancel the contract and cause the document to become void. This term voidable provides the party that remains unbound with the power to cancel the agreement and leave the other person or entity without payment or services. So here voidable means it is a valid agreement between the two parties. The main situation which occurs here is one party will remain bound to the terms of the contract, while the other may only need to supply something such as payment or another item of value. The unbound party can cancel the contract and cause the document to become void. Okay, so now it is clear what is void, what is voidable. Now, again, in detail, I will explain voidable contract with an example. So, here, this voidable contract, it is this form of contract is formed in case when one of the essential elements, that is free consent, is not present. See, this is very, very important. Whenever a contract takes place, there should be free consent. So if there is no free consent, then it becomes a voidable contract. If the consent of the party to a contract is not free, that is when it is formed due to coercion, undue influence, misrepresentation or fraud, the contract is said to be voidable at his option. The party whose consent is not free can avoid or repudiate the contract if he or she is intended to do so. A voidable contract is valid until it is avoided by the party entitled to do so. So the both the parties want to proceed, or if there is free consent, then no problem. If there is no free consent, or what we call there is an undue influence or coercion is there, one party, if they want to do not want to continue, then it becomes a void contract. So here, if you take an example, Y and Z are there. Y promises to sell his bike. Y, he wants to sell his bike to Z for the sum of 50,000 rupees. Here, the consent is acquired through force or coercion. Therefore, the contract is said to be voidable contract at the option of Y. He may avoid the contract or elect to be bound by it. So here, what happens now, if there is any force, if the cost of the bike, say it is some 2 lakhs, by force if Jed is asking for what we call a lesser amount by force or something like that, it becomes a voidable contract. If a person promises to do something for another person for a consideration, but the other person prevents him to do so, then the contract becomes a voidable contract at his option. When a party to the contract promises to perform an obligation within the particular time, then any failure on his part to carry out his obligation, whether fixed time, makes the contract voidable at the option of the promisee. So this is regarding the voidable contract. When coming to the void contract, here an agreement not enforceable by law is said to be void. Void agreement does not create any legal rights or obligations. It is devoid of legal effects altogether, or it is void ab initio, which means from the very beginning it is void. Example, an agreement with a minor or agreement without consideration. These contracts are void contracts. So here void contract, according to the Indian Contract Act 1872, a contract becomes void when it ceases to be enforceable by law. A contract when actually entered into by both the parties may be valid or binding on the parties. Example, contract to import goods from Pakistan becomes void when a war breaks out between the importing country and the exporting country. See, if there is a war is taking place, so we can't. So it's a the contract void ab initio. So you can't export and import. It will not take place. So therefore, it is void. And these two aspects are over, voidable and void. Now let us go to other aspect, which is a illegal agreement. Illegal agreement is an agreement when one goes beyond legally accepted rules of fundamental public policy. So this is very, very important. Any act or any contract or any agreement, it should be legal. If we are going beyond legally accepting rules of fundamental public policy, then what happens? It becomes it is criminal in nature, or which is immoral in nature. Illegal agreement has much greater significance compared to void contract. All illegal agreements are void, but all void agreements or contracts are not necessarily illegal. So therefore, all illegal agreements are void, but all void agreements or contracts are not necessarily illegal. Next, an illegal agreement is not only void among the parties, but also its impact will be on the collateral transactions that becomes fraudulent with the illegality. Collateral transaction means a subsidiary, incidental or auxiliary to the principal or original contract. Ram borrows 20,000 from Shyam and enters into a contract with an alien to import illegal goods. Shyam knows the purpose of loan. This transaction becomes a collateral transaction between Ram and Shyam for the principal agreement. The agreement is an illegal agreement since the principal agreement or original contract is illegal. When the principal agreement or original contract is void, collateral transactions would not be effected. In the above example, Ram entered into a void agreement with a minor. The contract between Ram and Shyam does not get affected. So therefore, here this is very, very important. Always we have to see whether the whatever action we are taking, for example, is it legal or illegal. That aspect we have to see. If it is illegal, then it is better to avoid. And this is very, very important statement. All illegal agreements are void, and void agreements or contracts are not necessarily illegal. So therefore, here we have an idea about voidable contract, about void contract, and also illegal agreement. And coming to the other aspect, unenforceable contract. A contract which is unenforceable in the court of law, due to some technical defects like absence of writing, where remedy has been barred by lapse of time, is called an unenforceable contract. See, here the concerned parties may carry out the contract, but in case of breach of such a contract, the aggrieved party would not be empowered to the legal remedies. So it is unenforceable, so due to some technical defects, absence of writing or something like that, then because of lapse of time also, it is unenforceable, and the aggrieved party is not empowered to the legal remedies. So this is regarding the classification based on validity. Okay, is it clear? So the four aspects you have to keep it in mind: voidable contract, void contract, illegal agreement, and unenforceable contract. So this is the classification based on validity. Next, we'll be discussing about the classification based on formation and classification based on performance. So classification based on formation. It is very clear, formed either by writing or by word of mouth. Here, from the conduct of the parties based on the conditions or situations. So here we have four aspects: expressed contract, implied contract, quasi contract, e-commerce contract. So expressed contract, as the term indicates, express. In the sense, you will be words spoken or written during the formation of the contract is called expressed contract. Here, offer or acceptance of any promise is made in words, then promise is said to be expressed. We are expressing it. Expressed promise would lead to an expressed contract. Very clear. Next comes the implied contract. Contract which is implied from the acts or conduct of the parties or course of dealings between them is termed as an implied contract. See, which is implied from the acts, conduct of the parties, course of dealings between them, result of specific acts of concerned parties, but not the expressed promise. See, for example, Y enters into public bus, or Y enters a restaurant, or here it is implied in the sense when we enter a bus, public transport, or it is our bounded duty to take the ticket. It is implied. When you go to a restaurant, you are supposed to pay the bill. Or when you have for lifting your luggage at the railway station, it is your duty to pay the charges, service charges for the porter. So these are the, it implies, it is what we call implied contract. So the contract act states the proposal or acceptance of any promise is made other than words. You're not, it is implied, no need of writing or expressing in words, it is implied. So it is these are the examples which we can give. And coming to the quasi contract, quasi contract is not at all a contract. It is entered intentionally by the parties. On the other hand, the quasi contract is created by law. It is similar to a contract where legal obligation is applied on a party who should perform it. It lays on the ground of equity that a person may not be allowed to enrich himself unjustly at the expense of another. See, this is very, very important. So a businessman forgot to take his goods from B's house by mistake. A businessman forgot to take his goods from B's house by mistake. B treats the goods as his own. B is bound to pay for the goods. So the goods does not belong to me. It belongs to the other person. And I am supposed to pay for the goods. So therefore, quasi-contract is not at all a contract. It is entered intentionally by the parties, is created by law, and a legal obligation is applied on a party who should perform it. Okay? So you can't gain anything in an unjust way. Okay? That is regarding the quasi-contract. Now coming to the e-commerce contract. A contract which is entered into by the two parties via internet. It is called an e-commerce contract. Here the individuals or companies develop network on internet that are attached, related with many other networks. There is an expansion of commercial transactions. So therefore, it is called e-commerce contract. So in classification based on formation, we have discussed about the explicit contract, implied contract, quasi-contract and e-commerce contract. So the third type of classification, it is a classification based on performance. So here, the extent up to which contracts can be performed can be categorized into four heads: executed contract, and we have a executory contract, unilateral or one-sided contract, bilateral contract. So now let us discuss about the executed contract. Executed means what? Means the task which is completed. Executed means task which is completed. A contract where both the parties have performed their respective obligations, it is an executed contract. P agrees to purchase a book for Q, which of cost rupees 500. P purchases the dictionary and Q pays the price of that book. Then it means that both the parties have performed their obligations. Therefore, the contract is said to be executed. In few cases, even after the completion of the contract, its influence may continue. When a person buys a bun from a retail store which contains a stone and it breaks one of his teeth, then he has a right to recover the damages from the seller. Coming to the other contract, executory contract. Here what happens, executory means something that remains to be carried. Still, some pending, if we have to carry it to get the result, some work has to be completed, that remains to be carried into effect. A contract where both the parties are yet to perform their obligations, it is an executory contract. The contract is executory when P does not purchase the book and Q does not pay any price. P agrees to engage Q as a servant from the next month onwards. It is an executory contract. That means here the work is not completed. Something it has to be carried out in future. So that is called executory contract. Coming to the unilateral contract. Here unilateral means one-sided contract. Only one party should fulfill his obligation during the formation of the contract, and the other party fulfills the obligation at the time of contract prior to the existence of the contract. These contracts are also termed as contracts which executed consideration. Say, for example, P near railway station permits the railway coolie to carry his luggage and place it in the carriage. Contract is formed immediately when the luggage is placed in the carriage. But coolie has already performed his obligation and P should fulfill his obligation, paying the reasonable charges to the coolie. So therefore here, it is called unilateral contract. So here, the person P has fulfilled his obligation and it is the responsibility of the other person to pay the charges, service charges for the coolie. So it is one-sided contract, or one party should fulfill his obligations during the formation of the contract, other party fulfills the obligation at that time of the contract prior to the existence of the contract. Okay, now coming to the bilateral contract, here contract means contract where the obligations of both the parties remain outstanding. Both the parties are outstanding at the time of formation of the contract. Thus, it is similar to executory contract, and it is not termed as contract with executory consideration. A bilateral contract means a contract where the obligation of both the parties remain outstanding at the time of formation of the contract. Thus, it is similar to executory contract, and it is also termed as contract with executory consideration. Bilateral contract is a most commonly used contract where both parties are required to do something. Mr. X offers his home for sale for 5 lakhs. Y agrees to purchase the home. It's a bilateral contract. Each party is required to do something. Y has to pay offered price and X has to transfer the ownership. So it is a bilateral contract. So this is about the classification based on performance. We have studied about executed contract, executory contract, unilateral contract and bilateral contract. So now, before ending the lesson, there is one more important topic which we have to discuss, that is regarding the what are the differences between void contract, voidable contract, illegal contract. As we have studied these terms earlier, now let us on some aspects, if let us take some 6 to 7 basic aspects, and in detail one by one, let us have a clear idea how they differ from each other. So void contract, voidable contract, illegal contract. Let us take some aspects like enforceability, validity, influence, voidable, what are the sections, or can we sue it in the court, legality. So these aspects let us take, and in detail let us have a clear idea among the differences of these contracts. So if you take a first one, enforceable, here in void contract, a void contract is not enforceable by law. This is very, very important. You please, all of you, keep it in mind. Void contract is not enforceable by law. Coming to the voidable contract, these contracts are enforceable by law at the option of one party, but not at the option of other or other. Okay, so therefore here one person is ready, is accepting, the other person differs, so therefore it is voidable. Both agree, then it becomes a valid contract. If one person agrees, other person rejects or is not in a position to go ahead, then it becomes a voidable contract. Coming to the illegal contract enforceability, no court will entertain or enforce illegal contract. So it is not at all accepted. Right from the beginning only, it is rejected. So illegal contract. Now, second aspect, let us take a valid contract, validity. A void contract is a valid contract until the contradictory situation occurs. So here, for example, void contract involves something illegal, say some gambling activity, then it is not a valid contract. Okay. See, for example, if it is legal, then there is no problem. But here what happens? No, it is legal, but what happened if the person is mentally not competent, then it becomes void. Okay, legal, but based on the competency, we are not supposed to enter into the contract. If he is a minor, we can't enter into the contract. Legal in the sense, it is not illegal, it is legal, but the competency also we have to see. So based on the competence, it becomes what we call void. Okay, coming to the voidable contract, it becomes valid contract only when both the parties agree. If one agrees, other disagrees, then it will not become a valid contract. And coming to the illegal contract, see here, illegal contracts are actually void contracts with broader scope. So it can't become a valid contract. Coming to influence, let us take influence as the basis and compare them with all the three. So if you take void contract, a contract may be valid while entering into contract. If it changes either due to circumstances, it becomes void. Initially it is valid contract. While entering into contract, if it changes either due to circumstances, coming days, if any changes takes place, it may become void. Similarly, in voidable contract, all voidable contracts are induced by coercion, fraud, misrepresentation, undue influence. So therefore, there is a lot of influences there and they can't be executed and they become a voidable contract. Illegal contracts are unlawful and are either valid or void contracts depending on circumstances. So, based on voidable, a contract becomes void by supervening impossibility or illegality. Say, any void contract, it becomes void by supervening impossibility or illegality. So if there is a impossibility exists or illegality exists, then what happens? The contract becomes void. So voidable contract becomes void if it is illegal or impossible. Voidable contract becomes void when the party whose consent is not free. So see here, if there is any force or something like that, then the voidable contract becomes a void contract. Illegal contracts are opposed to public policy and are null and void. Anytime we can't do anything, we can't execute them. And coming to the section, here in void contract, we have section 2J of the Act deals with the void contracts. Please remember, all void contracts are defined or deal with the section 2J. And coming to the voidable contract, they deal with the section 2I of the Act deals with the void contracts. Okay, voidable contracts. Next, no sections of law deals with illegal contracts. For illegal contracts, there is no section. Sue, void contract. These void contracts are not enforceable by law, hence cannot be sued. They are not enforceable. There is no question of sue. Will not exist. If the aggrieved party suffers loss in case of a voidable contract, then we can proceed against them. The parties entered under the illegal contracts cannot sue other party. So, if the contract is illegal, the question of sue will not exist. Okay? So, last point, legality. Void contracts are illegal. Voidable contracts are legal and hence the parties involved in it get relief. Illegal contracts are criminal in nature. So this is very, very important. So all void contracts are illegal. Illegal contracts are criminal in nature. Voidable contracts are legal and hence the parties involved in it gets relief. So here we have studied various aspects. We have studied about the different types of contracts or classification of contracts. We have in detail we have studied the classification based on validity, based on formation, and also based on performance. And we have in detail we have discussed about what is a void contract, voidable contract, and illegal contract. So these are the things. And I want to still give some more examples to you such that the concept becomes very easy. So I take a few examples of void contracts. Most void contracts involve something illegal in the subject matter that could indulge in gambling activities, criminal actions of one or both parties. So these contracts are not enforceable by law. So please note it down, they are not enforceable by law, they are not valid. So void contracts are not valid. And one party can breach the agreement, they can break the agreement. There is no way to recover anything because there is no legally binding agreement in effect. So you can't proceed further, there is no legal binding. If the contract applies to someone that is not mentally competent because of an illness or someone under the age of majority is a minor, it is void. So you can't enter into the contract. Impossible performance, impossible events. And if against the public policy, all lead to void contracts. Another void contract is something that will restrain various activities such as legal proceedings, the right to work, or the choice of who to marry. These are the things, they all come under the examples of void contracts. When we discuss about the examples of voidable contracts here, what happens now? Voidable contracts are still legal and valid with the enforceability in the courts. One or both parties can void the contract at any time in usual circumstances. Enforceability of the contract is null if one person is minor when entering into the agreement. This remains the case if the person does not have the mental capacity to enter into the contract. Others are void in a voidable situation. So here, if the court thinks that there is no competency or then what happens? No, the voidable contract becomes void. Okay, so voidable contracts generally will apply when one person is bound by performance or services. Other has more power because he or she rules what is necessary. Voidable contract must stipulate certain terms without a specific language. The bound party may have more chances of going to make it as a void contract. The person bound to the terms may have the power to make substitutions such as what materials to use or when to accomplish the various goals. So here one more aspect, with this we can conclude. Let us have final legal support for void and voidable contracts. The person that is in a contract with another party will need legal support to ensure that the contract is enforceable in the courts. If the terms or circumstances void the agreement, the person or entity will need to know this prior to pursuing legal action. The lawyer will protect the party in either situation. So it is very, very important whether the court accepts our case or not, whether is it illegal or is it void or it is valid or it is what we call voidable. These things we should have a clear idea. So then only we can, and if we don't have any idea, there are the people who can guide us. There are lawyers, they will be guiding us. So therefore, always stick on to the aspect of legal, it should be legal, and fulfillment, and there should not be any coercion or threat or something like that. So if it is both parties agree, then it is becomes a valid contract, and it becomes very easy for us to have a common understanding, and we can the contract can be fulfilled successfully. So we have a clear idea about different types of contracts, and also we have understanding the differences between different contracts with the illustrations. Thank you.